You're watching Unreal Ent Gaming. This is Gohan from Dragon Ball Z. You want to see me turn Super Saiyan, or should I take it to the next level? I'm also the narrator, too. Next time on Dragon Ball Z, make sure and smash subscribe to Unreal Ent Gaming.
An all-out war between the evil Saiyans led by Cumber against the Saiyans of Planet Plant with Yamoshi aiding them has now begun. With everything riving on the line, we've last left off with Cumber having to force Yamoshi in using his true power in order for Cumber to further gauge himself in finding a worthy enough adversary to test his power against. We are now ultimately brought back to the initial battle involving Yamoshi and Cumber, as everything that these two have been fighting for and against is now essentially going to be put on the line to see which one of the two are going to walk away from this battle in one piece. As once more before we begin, if you are new to this channel and have a love and passion for all things Dragon Ball and anime related, then be sure to go on ahead and smash that subscribe button and turn on all notifications by clicking on the bell icon to never miss a single upload. And if you guys love and enjoy Dragon Ball and cannot wait to see more, then be sure to go on ahead and slap a big fat like down below by giving this video a big thumbs up, along with checking out the official Dragon Ball Fan Mangas playlist located down in the description box below, to where there you will be able to find all the latest and best Dragon Ball Fan Mangas created by the community for the community. So be sure to take a minute to go on ahead and check that playlist out located down below. As we kick off the Beyond Dragon Ball Super Yamoshi Manga Chapter Number 5 special, as we last left off with Yamoshi having to beat Cumber down onto the ground, we've then learned that Cumber only wants to further fight Yamoshi to not only test his own abilities against him, but also see how strong Yamoshi is in finally finding a real challenger for Cumber to battle against in further having to grow as a warrior, as only then we get to observe how Yamoshi points his finger down onto the ground and redirects an attack directly in front of Cumber, as Cumber then goes on to tell Yamoshi to "That's what I'm searching for." As Yamoshi quickly steps back, he then goes on to question, "You wanna fight? You're gonna get it." But then he looks on over as the girls are now beginning to battle, as one of them goes on to comment, "It's okay. Yes, thanks," because now we understand that Sai had not only been freed from Cumber's influence, but she also goes on to comment, "So that's how you came to mind versus Yamoshi?" As Natsu responds, "Yeah. Let's not hang around. There are other evil Saiyans around." So, not only do we get to see from Natsu's perspective how Yamoshi's fighting against Cumber as she goes on to cry out he's not in Akari mode, but while we then get to observe them fighting, what's interesting about this is they acknowledge the fact that yeah, Yamoshi's not using his Akari mode against Cumber, but also, if you're fighting against any one of these evil Saiyans, there is a way to knock them back into consciousness as we've seen with Sai, but when we go back to Yamoshi and Cumber, the fight then begins to get really intense as Yamoshi cries out, "Astral Hammer!" But Cumber not only blocks off the attack, but he also breaks free as the two begin to go head to head, with Cumber having to punch Yamoshi so hard that it causes Yamoshi to stagger back, coughing up blood. And what's really cool about this is that this fight really isn't one-sided. Even with Yamoshi having to use more of his power against Cumber, we also then get to see how Yamoshi staggers back and crying out, "Damn, I resisted him because I was angry, but now," and as Yamoshi looks on, he sees how every single one of the Saiyans are struggling in battle against their own evil counterparts, who in fact are their own friends and family that Cumber had turned against them, with one of them crying out, "It really works! A simple hit well placed in the neck." So it appears that once you punch these Saiyans in the neck, there is a probable cause of them having to revert back to who they were before, as the Saiyans then go on to continue, "At this rate, we will not be able to win," with Kabura responding, "But we can save time for Yamoshi." So they're trying to save time for Yamoshi to then further gain the upper hand against Cumber, but then Kabura goes on ahead to spot Lord Chilled as he goes on to cry out, "You! You are the weirdo guy on the ship!" And with Chilled having to emerge, he then goes on to tell him, "Oops." Kabura then goes on to ask him, "Would you like to help us against the evil Saiyans? We are in the same situation anyway," as one of the Galactic Patrollers goes on to tell Kabura, "Are you stupid?" With Chilled having to respond, "You ask for my help? Is that it?" Interesting. As only then the Saiyan King also goes on to tell Chilled, if you help us, I'll ask the Galactic Patrol to spare you. As Chilled responds, to make a deal with you. So now the Saiyans are pleading with Chilled that they need his help, but with Chilled having to be very condescending, he then went along to comment, I'd prefer to die than join a band of monkeys. As he then fires an energy blast, eerily similar to that of the Death Beam, directly at the Saiyan King, to the shock of everyone, he then proceeds to blow a hole right in the Saiyan King's chest. And with the Saiyan King then having to cough up blood, and everyone having to look on, the Saiyan King went along to respond, you stupid monster! In the fact that they needed Chilled for this battle, but Chilled chose otherwise. As one of the Saiyans that happens to represent that of Vegeta's bloodline, angrily enough steps right in, he wastes no time in punching Chilled in the face. As the other Saiyans gather around the King, Okura then goes on to comment, Sadara! Please stay with us, as the King responds, I'm sorry, my dear. I hope Vegeta will have a great bloodline. So this is it. This is it for King Sadara. As Yamoshi and Cumber look on, Yamoshi goes on to cry out, Impossible! Not King Sadara! As Cumber angrily goes on to ask, the King? Which is fascinating, because with Cumber having to see the King go down, moments away from dying, this entire situation is insanely crazy from the jump, because with Cumber having to come here for the sole reason of wanting to get stronger and finding a rival, Chilled came here for a different purpose, but with Cumber acknowledging this, he quickly dashes on in, flying right by Yamoshi, knocking away Vegeta Jr., as he then proceeds to grab Lord Chilled by the face, which is insanely interesting to see how Cumber actually felt for the King. And with Cumber gripping tight on the face of Lord Chilled, Cumber went along to tell Lord Chilled, Vermin, I was the one who was supposed to kill the King, not a dwarf like you. As Cumber took it upon himself to blow Lord Chilled into pieces, as one of the other Time Patrollers goes on to comment, well, that's one less thing to worry about then, because we understand that Cumber wanted to be the one to kill the King, and being the fact that Lord Chilled got in his way, this was it. This was it for Chill, and Cumber had no, absolutely no remorse in killing him. The other Saiyans then gather around Cumber as they go on to tell him, here comes the final boss. Kamba, you will regret what you did to our nation. And with Cumber having to look around, the Saiyans continue, it's time to pay for your acts. Wild Cannon! So as everyone attempts to attack him, Cumber seems to easily deflect everyone's attacks. Yamoshi goes on to scream out, get out of here or you'll die! Not knowing the fact that Cumber is hiding a greater power, and if everyone continues to attack him the way they are right now, then they're most certainly going to die. But this doesn't stop Cumber from formulating a massive, gigantic energy ball above his head, as Cumber goes on to tell everyone, your friend is right. Now, disappear. As this attack is looking to literally end everything, what I find most fascinating here is the fact that Yamoshi is the only individual amongst the crowd that can even remotely compare to Cumber, while everyone else in this situation doesn't seem to stand the chance. And as Cumber holds this energy blast above his head, he then goes on ahead to throw this energy blast directly at Yamoshi, as Yamoshi goes on to ask, why is he just shooting at me? As everyone goes on to tell him, Yamoshi, don't just stand there! As Sai takes it upon herself to aid Yamoshi in this situation, this is very grim, and there is a reason why Cumber specifically aimed at Yamoshi and not anyone else. And with Sai simply having to get in the way, Yamoshi goes on to question her, but then she goes on to tell him, alone, you won't be able to do it. Let's go. As Yamoshi agrees by stating, here we go, they both combine their attacks as they cry out, Victory Hammer, and combining their attacks as it finally makes contact with Cumber's massive energy ball, Kabura cries out, here we are too, Wild Cannon. So everyone is banding together in this act of having to not only try to figure some kind of a way in deflecting Cumber's attack, but as this is happening, out of nowhere, with all of their powers having to be combined into one, it finally works. They conjure up enough strength to finally get rid of Cumber's attack, but then, as Cumber is standing behind the smoke, he goes on to comment, not bad, and fires a blast that ends up going right through Sai's chest, to in which is eerily similar, very similar to what happened with King Sidara, and with Sai having to then hit the ground, her final words are "Yamoshi," and with Cumber having to stand through the smoke, seemingly as if nothing ever happened to begin with, he went along to comment, "I thought I touched Yamoshi. It's nothing." And as Yamoshi stands there, shocked, wordless in what he is seeing, he goes on to state, "Sai's... no." And with Sai having to lay on the ground with a massive hole in her chest, her final words before passing are, "Yamoshi, I love you." And this was the moment, this was what was used to finally trigger Yamoshi. Because Yamoshi's inner thoughts are, "Sai, why you?" Because then he begins to have thoughts and memories reoccur to when he was with her. Every experience, every moment that he's ever had with her had now been quickly remembered, as only then Yamoshi's emotions begin to pour out as he cries out, "Why you?" And erupting in a massive fit of rage, with everything having to be destroyed around him, we then begin to bear witness as Yamoshi uses the pain of loss as a trigger for transforming. All the other Saiyans around Yamoshi go on to comment, "Wow, what is he doing now?" As Kabura comments, "I don't know, it's the first time." And with this massive, massive explosion having to take place, further pushing Cumber back, Cumber goes on to comment, "That's what you were hiding." So Cumber knows that Yamoshi had this deep down this entire time, and he did everything he could to finally trigger Yamoshi in transforming, as by the end we get to bear witness for the first time Super Saiyan Yamoshi finally step on the battlefield as he lets out a terrifying roar. The manga chapter special then comes to a close. Now, this is going to be setting up the inevitable battle between Super Saiyan Yamoshi and Cumber in the next special, to in which right now you can see the level of depth, the level of emotion, and the level of loss that Yamoshi has been experiencing, because friends, family, the king, and now the woman that he cared about most is gone. Everything that Yamoshi had ever been fighting for was essentially ripped away by Cumber, and now that Cumber was requesting to have this actually be brought onto the surface is what's going to be further used against Cumber in battle. But in the end, I want to get your thoughts in the comment section below. With Cumber having to use this hatred and this bloodlust to continuously fight, do you guys think that this is perhaps going to be Cumber's final moments against Yamoshi, or is Yamoshi simply going to trigger something within Cumber that forces Cumber in transforming down the line? I want to get your thoughts in the comment section below. Thank you all so much for watching, guys. Once more, if you are new to this channel, don't forget to go on ahead and smash that subscribe button and turn on all notifications to never miss a single upload. Give this video a big thumbs up by slapping that like button down below. Tune back in for the next video. Right now, we're only setting the stage for what's going to happen down the road, which of course right now it would appear that Yamoshi is losing people left and right, and this is what was used in revealing his true power, and now that it's brought onto the surface, the question is, how is Cumber going to respond? Thank you all so much for watching once more, and I'll be seeing you all down in the comment section below. Take it easy, guys. Peace! And a quick little reminder before you guys go, if you guys are unaware, I do have a second gaming channel located down in the description box below, so be sure to head on over to Unreal Royale and hit that subscribe button along with turning on all notifications, as to there, you guys will find all different kinds of gaming content that you will not get to find on Unreal and Gaming, titles and video games such as Grand Theft Auto, Call of Duty, Gears of War, Dragon Ball Z Dokkan Battle, Dragon Ball Z Legends, Dragon Ball Z Budokai Tenkaichi 3, Minecraft, Blair Witch, and many other retro games on that channel. So if you guys are into gaming, then make sure you guys subscribe over on Unreal Royale. I want to thank you all so much for your time, and I'll catch you all in the next one.
This is the Galactic Emperor of the Universe, and of course I'm here to tell you to subscribe to Unrelent Gaming.
Also follow Unrelent Gaming on these social media platforms to stay connected at all times. And if you don't, then very soon you will all be dead! Oh, did someone say Unrelent Gaming? Oh my god.
The fuck, Zarbon? Put on some clothes!
Well, why don't you put on any clothes?
What? I don't need clothes, but Jesus Christ, that's huge! What, Broly?
Freezer.
Uh-oh.
Prepare to die!
Boo, I'm a real gaming! Boo, once you get video, I'll lots of likes! Or Boo will turn you into chocolate!
Vados, get over here! Tell these socials that I'm the biggest Unreal Ant Gaming fan. This is my moment. I'm a part of his notification squad. Universe 7 can have all the fun. I just want the food.
And don't forget to leave a comment on this video. Show some love for the best community on YouTube.
Cuck. Cuckoo!